Well, hello everyone, I am Fracture, and this is Let's Play Divine Divinity on the PC. And we're just trying to... I shouldn't have walked away from him so quick. We're just trying to finish off this quest. This guy's a thief, and he's selling under-the-counter goods. Now, we're supposed to sort of expose his suppliers. Well, not that way. We're supposed to find a note in the sewer. So I think it was in the right place. What is this? Is this it? Actually, no, I think that wasn't it, but I'm going to pick it up because they did say there's a note. And if I kept it, we'll be lucky. I don't think I did, so. And it's not highlighting when I hit Alt. The only thing I can hope for is that maybe I kept it in my inventory back at the ranch. But while we're here...
I can't use that.
Let's grab another one of these chests while we're here. Yes, did you know you could do that?
I'll have to drop something. I'm carrying too much.
Too much? You've got room for one more.
I'll have to drop something. I'm carrying too much.
I did it again. Yeah, I gotta get out of the habit of clicking the teleporter stone when it's in my inventory, because it doesn't drop it when you do that. Which means now if I want to get back to town, I have to take the long way. So I was just... Am I still encumbered? No, I can move. So this is why I picked up those chests. You can collect chests. And it gives you places to store stuff. And since I was right there, and I don't need to rest, I figured I'd grab a few. Well, I'm going to turn off wraps. You don't need to see me run to the teleporter. I'll see you back in town. Okay, and we're back. So I stopped Fraps before I had actually looked for that note in my inventory in the house. And at least I remembered before I got too far. I couldn't find another note, just that one I found in the sewers, which I don't think is the right one. While I was there, though, I also cleaned out this little triangle. This is one area of the map that I hadn't cleared off. So as you can see, I have now. Nothing of interest. Yes. So... I would have expected that since I had that note in my inventory, if it was the right note, I would have had something to say about it. The only other thing that might happen is maybe drag and drop, but I really doubt it. No. He just throws it on the ground. And it's as good of there as anywhere. Okay, so I think unless I stumble across that note, I lost it in my travels, I don't particularly care. That also may not be the place in the sewers where the note is residing, I suppose. But I would think it would light up. And I'm not going to go through all of these chests. All of them say there's nothing, 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 nothing. Yeah, so... So my guess is, what, another... quest missed, because it's certainly not standing out, and I could see no reason why the cache would be a different one from the obvious, so let's just give up on that quest for now. And let's take a look at the quest book for other things we can do. Kill Barathis, oh yes, forgot about that one. Elven Council Member. That's interesting, Dwarven Council Member. Ah, yes. So, this Dwarven Council Member apparently is by the Dwarven City we only recently uncovered. That was just north of here. So let's take a look at the map. Make sure I'm not getting off track, or was it just south of here? Oh, this is it right here. So yeah, it is just south of here. Was there a teleporter nearby? Yes, teleporter, Dwarven Village. So now, as you recall, there's this interesting meeting stone that apparently is supposed to have somebody interesting nearby, but it looks pretty generic to me. I don't think this is him. I was misled, and my understanding was that after we had seen that stone that showed us the various council members, the seven council members, apparently there was supposed to be some guy hanging around here, and I don't see him. Oh, and every time we pass by this guy just rambles on. Soldier, soldier, soldier. Oh yeah, that was a challenge. Yeah, you'd think word had spread. Well, no, I guess it can't, can it? I suppose if I was smart, I would leave the occasional one alive.
Locked tight.
Not tight enough. Just a second. Get these guys to take care of first. Then we'll come back to these. We have lockpick somewhere. Buried under other... Where did I put my lockpick skill? Oh, F2. I should try and remember that.
Locked.
Witchers, heavy leather... Watchers, heavy leather boots. It's nothing particularly good. Couple of bombs. 6 items. Egg, nothing. All right. So we have the elves... still to do. We have... Where are this Council of Seven here? The Elves, the Dwarves, Human Council Member, Lizard Council Member. I think we're in trouble. I think I'll go and read on the internet where these guys are. So why this specialty character isn't here? I don't know. He was supposed to be. Well, since I don't have much I can think of doing, let's head south again. I can see that there's an interesting town that I don't think we made it to, if nothing else. And that could end up a little bit more interesting than just wandering around. Or did we? Would that count as that town? There's the talking tree. That might be it. I mean, there's not a lot to it, though. This isn't a huge area of the map. Baratus House, okay. Well... let's head back to town and see if we can get any more elf information. I'd said I'd wanted to do this anyway. I didn't talk to everybody in town, nobody was that talkative, and we were just kind of getting generic chatter. But I didn't try to get inside all of these buildings and that sort of thing. So It's just this. Careful, human. Yeah, sorry. Hail and well met, human. Some told me that you're a charitable, kindly person. Maybe you have elf blood in your veins. Hello, what's new among your people? It is said that you're human overlord, Duke Janus. Yep. So we have this kind of generic jibber-jabber. That's not really... Can you not see that all these troubles keep me busy? Troubles? Tell me more about your problems. Ah, okay. So I suppose we could pursue this sort of love quest thing that I stumbled into. I have spoken to your daughter, Elanessa. Her beauty is beyond mortal words can to describe. Be mindful of your words, human. I have seen the lecherous look in your eyes when you spoke with her. Attempt to approach her again and I will kill you. I think it's time I was leaving. You want to trade? Lich's closed helmet. Plus 80 to magic. Plus 1 resistance to poison. Meh. Armor 200, though. It's not bad. Right, time I was leaving. Let's see if he'll talk about these troubles. Troubles? Tell me more about your problems. We prepare for war against those damned dwarves. The bearded fools have defiled our sacred burial grounds, and now they shall pay. It is time I was leaving. So I think we really have seen everything there is to see in this area. Well, when in doubt, head further south. Let's see what's out here. Ooh, there's music out here. See, now a smart troll would run when he saw his two friends drop dead. Making pretty good experience off those guys, anyway. Hello, I see you hidden back there. Whale's Long Dagger. Nothing of particular interest. There, well, I was out of mana anyway, so even if I'd had it prepped, it's not like this is healing me all that much anymore. But let's use up some of this ridiculous stuff that I'm carrying around. Finished meal. Well, we don't need that. I think it's neat that it left it there. Follow the path. These guys actually do a considerable amount of damage when they do hit me. But they're giving 10,000 experience, so I guess if they did no damage, that would be a little lopsided. Kind of hints at a fork in the road, but it's not really. Ah! Well, a big stack of trolls there, and I drank far too many potions doing that. Well, they'll still do a little something. And we've got some vials we should probably use up. I've seen some motions. I've seen some mushrooms in this area, so. Like those, and they're up on top of a plateau. Oh, I was going to say we've come to the end of the path, and no, not quite. This could be good or bad. And I'm thinking bad. What's that? Funeral pyre, maybe? Funeral pyres? Ooh. Yeah, this might be like a dwarven burial grounds. Or, well, yeah, I'm thinking because of the mining picks and things. Do dwarves burn their dead? Well, just in case it is a burial ground, I'm not going to go looting. Wonder if this is the area that the elves were PO'd about as well. No, can't get through there. I'm curious. Let's try the other way. It's got to be something like that. I wonder if we have found the area of contention. Whose teleporter was that? Yeah, burial grounds. I'm sure last time I played this game, I went down in here first. I've never been down here in any of my Let's Plays. Or in any of my, like, just... Yeah, so that was the town. Look at that. That little elven blob supposedly is the same... Well, you know, I think that Verdistus is more than twice the size of this little elven blit that was barely a farm. Can I get through here? No. So that's my thought. This is the area that the elves were pissed off about. This is their sacred lands, and the dwarves are using it as a burial ground. Could be. Could be nothing of the sort as well. Wouldn't mind trying to get around it, though. Darn plateaus. Nothing. And I may... The other thing I can do is actually backtrack. As I said, I do recall the last time I played this game many years ago. After visiting the main area that we've pretty much completed, I ended up in a desert region that was also south of the main area, so that's what I expected when I came down onto this area of the map, and was a bit surprised when it was about as far from a desert region as you can get. And while we're here, we could also go ahead and try and kill that tree. I think it's quite killable. The only reason we really need to kill it is to get its bark. If we were to finish that quest from Verdistus, where the lady needs some bark and some wine, And then we learn how to summon. Personally, this character has no interest in summoning. Small, large, large, empty.
Yes!
Do we have six? Yeah, we've got six empty flasks. Good.
Ha! Brilliant!
I think we're done there. And I may put my next point into... Well, I can't decide, really, because the other place I'd like to put my next point is Lockpick. We've walked past a couple of places where I'd like to have a higher Lockpick skill. I think a couple of them were in Verdistis. When we walked around in the sewers, we wanted to go up and, well, ostensibly rescue that girl's cat. And those doors were locked and I couldn't pick them. So maybe with another point in Lockpick I could. I'm kind of hoping I'd find a piece of equipment that lets me do that instead of wasting a skill point. But oh well. I'll probably get impatient.
Yes!
One of the things I've considered doing with these Let's Plays as well, and this might be the perfect opportunity to experiment, is I can speed these up quite easily. And that's usually how I check my own Let's Plays. I actually play them back at 200% speed, and I can listen to my rambling and make sure I didn't say anything particularly stupid. I'd have to say something outrageously stupid for me not to post it, because I don't really care. But it's a quick way to test. Oh yeah, it's way up here. And there's a teleporter, though. I can take a shortcut. And it actually sounds fine. I mean, speeding things up nowadays, it used to be you speed things up and you end up sounding like Mickey Mouse. But nowadays, it keeps the pitch more or less the same. So I might try that on this one, because I'm pretty much doing nothing, as you can see. Let's see, Elven Ruins. Interesting. We could work our way towards that as well. Anyway, what I'm getting at is I might take this video and actually run it at about 100-150%.
Brilliant!
And just see what sort of comments I get. Because you really don't miss anything, especially on a slow one like this where I'm just kind of wandering around and, you know, picking mushrooms for goodness sake.
Brilliant!
So why not fit 30 minutes of video into 20? Actually, I wish YouTube would let you do that. Play videos back at faster than normal speed. I can certainly see why they don't. I mean, it'd be quite the technical nightmare. They've got their system tuned so it streams at reasonable rates and they can kind of predict how much bandwidth they're going to need and that sort of thing. And if they start letting you run things at faster rates, that becomes a bit of a technical battle to stream properly. Especially if you let people switch back and forward, you don't know, should I be streaming and skipping every third frame, or should I be buffering as if they're not going to be running it at fast speed? So, you know, all solvable things, but technically a bit of work. Actually, one of the things I noticed since I've been messing around with, Netflix, and they're streaming. They seem to... Charm plus one. Alright, well, I'll hold on to that. They seem to do something that I think is wise. I'm surprised YouTube doesn't do it. They're streaming. They specifically only stream ahead a few minutes. I guess they know that you're not going to be skipping around in a movie that much. Or at least most of the time you won't. But if you pause, they stop streaming, whereas YouTube continues to stream. It buffers the whole video even if you're pausing it. And I'm kind of surprised YouTube doesn't try to save bandwidth. So if I pause the video, it buffers for a couple of minutes. Well, I guess that's probably kind of the remains of them having videos limited to 10 minutes. What was the big deal, you know? If they're going to buffer ahead a few minutes from where you pause, they may as well buffer the whole thing. Not so much now, where they're letting people 20, 30-minute videos. They probably should look into the whole, stop streaming it if I stop watching it sort of thing. I wish they'd spend more time on that sort of technical stuff than screwing up the effing homepage and that kind of crap. That's the stuff they always seem to be messing with. The stuff Brilliant. Nobody wants.
Yes. Ha!
Of course, I suppose Let's Players are a bit of the exception, but I would love to see YouTube kind of manage multi-volume things, and they've already got playlists, so I wish you could manage playlists better. So if I'm subscribed to, say, a Let's Player that's doing 3 Let's Plays, me, for example, I didn't subscribe to myself, but here's that tree. If I'm subscribed to somebody that's doing 3 Let's Plays and I'm only interested in one of them, most Let's Players put their Let's Plays into playlists. So it would be nice to be able to say, ignore these 2 playlists and subscribe to this one and any new ones they may create. Come on, hit him. Oh, I can't hit him. Yeah, I thought I would just be able to kill him like any other... Let's see if he's gonna... What are you still doing here? Nope. This would be a good place to... What kind of experience do I get? Kind of an endless experience if you wanted. So again, I got sidetracked and forgot where I was in my rant. But I guess, what I'm saying is if YouTube really knew what people were doing... Back off with that weapon. I'm sorry. Of course, it used to be quiet place before all the mess with Duncan. Get rid of it. So I think these are the guys that told me about the tree. Yeah, so we can skip these guys. So yeah, I think, they should kind of work a little bit more on the playlist. They've got that 200 video limit in the playlist. And they've got to do a way better job of remembering which videos I've watched. And now that their videos can be longer than 10 minutes, they definitely need a way to mark my place easily partway Brilliant. Through a video as well. So, like right now, if you hop on the playlist,
yes,
and there's 200 videos in it, it's not that easy to manage. They could have done such a better job of it. That queue thing is okay, but you can see it was added as an afterthought. And again, they didn't do a very good job of it. Minus 21 resistance to spirit. Oh yeah. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Super poison! Super happy fun poison!
Ha! Brilliant! Yes!
Pick it up. The whole YouTube interface from start to finish is awful. And getting worse. I wish they would... There's so many places they could just directly monetize it. I don't know why they don't. There's a lot of companies out there doing quite well by upselling. You get it for free. YouTube, leave YouTube the way it is. But then have people pay to either subtract things from it. Like... If I wanted to pay and have no ads, you know, I could do that. If I wanted to pay, I don't think they can do this. I think the limitations on my end. Pay so that I could upload videos faster, or pay so I get higher rankings. I don't know. I'm not. There's got to be ways they can make money off the thing and make their customers happier. Now they just seem to be making it worse. I don't know what they had in mind with that new interface change. I'm looking for lockpick again, and I know I've got a hotkey for it. I don't know why I don't just... all that work, and there's nothing of any import. The only thing I can think of why they would do such an awful homepage revamp when nobody wanted it is that they've got something in mind, some way of getting people to accidentally click on ads by sneaking them into their playlists or something. There's got to be some reason behind such an awful design. You know, and I was reading, they finally put a blog entry about it. Oh, look, we've given the new homepage to everybody. Everybody's had it for a while, and some people disliked it, but the majority of people said they preferred it over the old homepage. Well, there's a bit of a flaw in that logic. First of all, you know, that's like, you know, enjoying a Ford Focus over a Yugo. They're both pretty awful, and you're comparing awful to awful, so what choice do you have? But the people that filled out the questionnaire are the people that stayed on that version of the homepage long enough to even notice there was a questionnaire option while it was in beta. I don't know about you, but I tried it and within seconds had turned it off, and I didn't even realize there was a questionnaire that I could have filled out and told them what I thought of it. And I have a feeling the majority of people are in the same boat. Now, there's, you know, I kind of agree. I know people think, why are you ranting? There's nothing's going to happen. They've done it before, and they knew it sucked, and they did nothing about it. And I agree. That's exactly what's going to happen. Still fun to rant. You know, they say, oh, we listen to what people want, and clearly not, because you can't make a mistake that bad. You know, if you so much glanced at the way people were using the system, they never would have come up with that design. So, I mean, they're a money-making business. Well, they must be. I can't see them being actually a money-making business right now. Not the bandwidth that they're supplying and what they're giving away for free. You know, I've got 500 and some odd videos, each a minimum of 10 minutes, so... If you look at this video is a bit of a different one, but if you look at something like my Deathspank videos, 15 minutes is almost half a gig. So, you know, I've got probably, 20 to 30 gig on their hard drives for free. Now, if I did that with Dropbox or something, that's going to cost me $100 a year on Dropbox. They're overcharging. I mean, that's a bit of a ripoff, but, you know, that's how can they do that for free? So it's hard to complain. They're giving me all that for free. Yeah, ads. Yeah, blah, blah, ads. No big deal. I've never clicked on an ad ever on YouTube. I've closed them plenty of times, and they're getting worse and worse and more annoying. Typical marketing, you know, oh, the only reason people aren't clicking on their ad, on our ads, because they're not intrusive enough. If we just made them more annoying and more impossible to get past, then we'll have people flocking to our site and wanting to buy our products. And you think I'm kind of joking. I've dealt with marketing people, and that is exactly how they think. Our ad is so fantastic. The only thing that's stopping people from loving it is it's not in your face enough. You know, you got to wonder. The other thing I've noticed, everybody must have seen this, but YouTube, there's a couple of places where YouTube has queues called things like rental videos and that sort of thing, but I've never seen any rental videos in YouTube, even looking for them. But then you have these services like Netflix that seem to be doing just fine. I read all the news about Netflix is a dying service and they're not going to survive and all that sort of stuff. I don't know about that. You know, I like it. They're just the flip side. In Canada, the streaming only Netflix, it's got a pretty limited selection, but it's under $8 a month for unlimited streaming, unlimited videos. And as luck would have it, their limited selection is kind of the stuff I want to see. It's like old BBC serials. It's like lots of old Doctor Who stuff, Mystery Science Theater 3000. Lots of good stuff. How come YouTube isn't exploiting that? They must have access to just vast quantities of better stuff. I suppose if they're making any money, I still can't see how they could be breaking even on bandwidth costs and disk costs. But I guess if your community is giving you all this video for free and then you monetize it. But even that being said, they don't monetize it by default, do they? I mean, if I post a video, you know, I can choose to have it monetized, and then they take a cut. But, I don't know, it just baffling. Maybe I'm not applying economies of scale enough for YouTube. You know, I'm thinking, well, you know, if I buy 2 terabyte drive, you can get them. If you're in the market for, say, a 2 terabyte drive, you're not going to have too much trouble paying $60 for 2 terabytes. You'd have to look for a bit, but you can find them. But I'm not buying petabytes and etabytes, which YouTube must be. So they're probably getting them for, like, what I would have to pay $60 for. I can only imagine, like, they have a direct feed from these manufacturers. They must be paying $10 for the same drive, if that. So $10 for 2 terabytes. Their biggest overhead is probably throwing out dead drives. Okay, well, we've wandered around. How much have we done? Well, not a whole lot. We kind of cleared out a chunk here. And I rambled and rambled, and I'm ready for a break. And you know what I think I'll do in the next video, if you're curious? This looks like a bit of a dead end at the moment. I'm sure there's stuff around here, and maybe if I do a little bit more reading. I think what I'm going to do is head north again and find my way to... I don't think I can... How do I go to world map? Trophies, conversations... No, I can't remember. Doesn't matter anyway. I'm going to head north, and then head south and try to get into that desert area that is actually right about here. So that's over to the east of this area. Because I remember that being quite exciting. Some interesting trolls and some desert fights and stuff. So even though we're probably leaving a bunch of quests hanging, what the heck, I want to have a little bit more exciting one of these next time. And I think I will play this back a little faster speed and see what people think. Anyway, so we will see you. Have a good one, and I will do my little speech. I will say I thank you for watching, and I thank you for listening. I encourage you to leave comments, suggestions, or infantile abuse. I promise I read it all. And if you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel or give me the thumbs up. And we'll see you next time. Have a good one, folks. Cheers.